Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today, for this horrible Monday, I have a special guest, which is WZ Tier 8 Chinese Tank Destroyer. And oh boys, I can tell you, I had a nightmares of this vehicle. I was dreaming how I was getting tortured by this tank, and this tank was tickling my feet pads. It was absolutely disgusting, but you know what? We marketed it anyways. I had a legendary session with this tank. I don't really think I would ever be able to repeat it. We played 33 battles with this tank for average damage of 3,100. It is insane for this vehicle. And for 300 assisting damage. Which is absolutely epic, and it is absolutely legendary, fellas. And plus, on top of that, we did not even spam it the full gold with this tank. So I'm very, very proud of myself, what we have done. If you are curious what equipment we was using, we was rolling with this kind of equipment, right? And I believe only one thing what we need to do, we need to say we finished it in 119 games, 2,400 average damage and 300 assisting damage. You can imagine how our average performance was looking like before this session. Just saying. So now, all we need to do, we need to say a goodbye for this vehicle, and obviously we are selling it and we are forgetting about this vehicle existence. 1429790. This is very, very, very enjoyable moment to sell this tank. Believe me, I was waiting quite a bit for it. And now what we are going to do, I will share two games with this vehicle, the best two games which we had, and you will see yourself. The first battle is going to be mind-blowing, I can promise you that. Anyways, without further ado, let's teleport into the gameplay. And we are back, fellas. Funny fact, this battle was the last game to get 100% on this vehicle, and we did this successfully. And I was tryharding this session quite a bit, I must admit that, fellas. Skill, why are you shit-talking this tank destroyer that much? What is wrong with this tank destroyer? Skill, I don't get it. So quick information, the gun handling of this vehicle is not great, you are missing a lot of shots. Armor of this tank is not reliable, but you know what, even broken clock is showing time twice correctly a day. Keep this in mind, and this is battle, this game is going to be definition of this madness, fellas. What you are going to see right here is going to be crazy. Armor working, gun handling hitting, enemies are getting PSD from us. It is insane. Anyways, let's see how the things are looking like, and let's focus on this game. So how we are starting this battle? We are starting this battle from the typical Foxtrot 4 position. I love this position with light tanks, medium tanks, and some tank destroyers. With heavy tanks, it is not so useful. But that's completely fine. So first of all, we are just waiting until someone will get spotted, and I even pinged into the position where someone should get spotted. Pilot is getting spotted, and pilot is gonna already. Our light tank is like the best team ever. I did not had better team than this. I believe this is what our gentleman is thinking. Anyway, Suka Pershing, open field. I'm thinking maybe we could smack him once or twice. And can you peek? Maybe peek a bit more, pretty please? Pretty please? Oh yes, nice. 490 in the face. I thought I'm not going to get spotted because no one could spot us from here. So I am feeling so far so good. And another shot, and Suka Pershing is dead. That's absolutely amazing, and we are feeling very great. Now we are going up on the rails, and we are trying to find a good angle for a people which are playing, which are getting effed. Meanwhile, Borat is spotted. I am thinking maybe we can smack him, maybe guard. Luckily, our armor lasted, and as you can see, none of the damage taken. One more thing which I do not really understand from Wargaming, and what is the logic behind this tank having 1000 HP. Even Scorpion G, fellas, which has no armor whatsoever, it has 1050 HP. Dede Fede has like 1500 HP. Why this vehicle is sitting on 1000? It is madness, fellas. It is beyond me. But once again, World of Tanks never ever was known for being good at balancing stuff. So let's not complain and let's simply do what we can do with this tank. And this tank is pretty damn good smacking enemies for 500 in the face. It is truly strong vehicle for that, but only when gun is working. If gun is not working, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, then the tank is obviously not going to behave, and this is not going to be a great situation and enjoyable gaming experience. Anyways, I noticed that we lost the east flank completely, so what we are doing now, we are going for a base defense for obvious reasons. I am thinking about loading hits from now on, because I am one shot away from getting up to 100% of Mark of Excellence. Heat ammunition on. Yip, hooray. Very nice. So, who we are going to meet here on the corner? E75TS. That looks and that smells like beautiful 500 in the face, don't you think so? Mr. E75TS, show yourself. I have a gift for you, buddy. I have a gift for you. Now, you see, E75TS have very interesting armor, and you cannot penetrate this all the time. This shot was on me. I aimed to his thickest part of the booty, so not a big surprise. We are not penetrating him. Meanwhile, pay attention at the score in the background. We are losing on 2000 HP, and we are losing on two tanks already. So this is not looking very great. Although, speaking about the hit points, we are losing on 3000 HP already, and still on the two tanks. Let's make it 3.4. Yeah, fellas, it is not looking that great. I'm obviously trying to hit IS-5, because I knew T-44 has a great reload time, so he is going to be able to beat the living crap out of this gentleman. Unfortunately, no luck into the shot to the IS-5, but that's okay. What can you do? Nothing. We are losing on 3000 HP, fellas, which is once again not great thing, and I would love to smack this IS-5, but unfortunately this vehicle is pretty slow. We definitely do not have turret, and once again, fellas, I do not touch tiger whiskers, or however they are called, you know. I'm not doing this because RNG has its limits too, so keep this in mind. So I'm thinking maybe we can take this position and provide our team with a crossfire, but as you can see, we are getting outspotted, and we know Hash is trying to get a bit more involved. So what we are doing, we are going back for obvious reasons, because I do not want to be on the open field whenever this gentleman is going to peek. It is just not really worth the time and effort, and fellas, this is not what we want to do. Meanwhile, Su took one from the ISU, but unfortunately he took ISU out of the game. The situation is 7-11. We are losing by 2,700 HP and many other stuff, so this is looking very bad, fellas. I'm not going to lie for you, this is looking bad, and this is looking like a defeat. Our team is melting. Borat, I'm reloading high explosive ammunition for obvious reasons. We are smacking Borat with the high explosives for 570 in the face. I am lucky enough not to get penetrated by the guard and by the Borat, and now I'm thinking, no, Borat, you had a great run. And our Fava is finishing this gentleman off, which is completely fine. I am not complaining. Situation is looking a bit better than before, because we are losing only on 2,400 HP, but still enemies have an advantage over tanks, and I believe that's pretty visible, and this is understandable. Plus on top of that, our gun got hit, and the situation is looking so much worse now. Although TN Hash is down to one shotable, I'm thinking about smacking light tank even with a damaged gun, and light tank is taking one for the team, which is great. The deficit of HP is getting lower and lower, because enemies are trying to get involved. Luckily, this guy did not penetrate us like this, and this is extremely good thing for us. So whenever our track is going to be fixed, and it is fixed, he is going back to the garage. Excellent. Situation is looking better. HP difference is getting a bit more similar, which is great. And I am thinking this IS-5 is going to try to move like this. Or maybe light tank will move like this. Beautiful. Light tank got caught and light tank is not enjoying himself anymore. Score is getting better and better and better. What do I mean by saying that? Now we are equal with the tanks. And obviously, actually, we are having tank advantage now. And I still have HP. What that means? That means I can trade and I can peek against the ISU if I really want to. And now you might think, but skill, why you are not fixing the gun? Well, the answer is very simple. Chinese tanks are working better when they know they are broken. And as you can see, I did not even bother it to fix the gun. So guard is only one who is alive. And have you saw the comeback of this battle? At one point, if I'm not mistaken, we were losing by 4,000 HP and like 4 to 5 tanks. So what we have done there, it was absolutely legendary, it was amazing, and this is mind-blowing performance with this vehicle. It is the best game which I had, and it happened that was the last battle with this tank destroyer. Skill, this tank is rated, how this tank is rated in the index, I will show you in a second and I will explain you why. Let's teleport into the second game. Funny fact, fellas, this is the game which I had the same day when we had Epic Game, and Epic Game was last game, and that was the first game of the day. I don't know, we had some kind of interesting situation. Anyways, on the index, fellas, how you are finding the tanks, you can click over there to see the full list, or you can simply type the name. In this kind of situation, we are typing the name, and as you can see, vehicle is rated by the bad. Why did I rate this vehicle bad? Because the tank itself is pretty horrible and it's pretty dreadful. It is just not a great vehicle. Combination of the things, like I said before, is just bad. There is nothing to say about it. Anyways, if you are struggling with the field modifications and stuff, fellas, remember there is index for your help, how you are finding it. You can Google skill for L2 index, or alternatively check out description down below and you will find everything yourself. So yeah, anyways, first battle of the day, and I was mentally prepared to get tortured by this vehicle, fellas. And people which was in the stream, you know how much I hated and how much I hate this vehicle. So I was mentally prepared to hate myself when I'm playing with this tank and just, you know, be calm or try to stay calm to the maximum. But what we have done, we have made history in a way for playing for this kind of score on this vehicle. It was absolutely amazing and it was absolutely insane. Anyways, so what we did, we punished crossing forces once in the face each time, which is very good. And now we loaded heat ammunition, which has, by the way, 340 penetration. But unfortunately, we did not manage to penetrate Russian tank, which kind of sucks. But it is how it is. We cannot complain too much about this. And remember, we can always try to repeat the same situation, aiming for cheek. As you can see, marker is green and bam, 590 in the face. And now you might think, but skill, how tank like this can be rated bad even though alpha damage of this vehicle is so damn great? Well, you see, fellas, not everything is in alpha damage. If the gun handling is trolling you to the maximum, unfortunately, but you are not going to get that much use with this vehicle. And one more thing which is worth to highlight, I was using this vehicle to complete mission, which is to do 3 times more damage than your vehicle have hit points, 3 times in a row. I did it with this tank, so if you are struggling with this mission, maybe this is the tank with which you can do that, although be prepared to, yeah, take a bit for the team, because it is definitely not the tank for the people which loves play with the competitive vehicles, right? So keep this in mind. Anyways, other than that, yeah, I don't even know what I'm supposed to say about this tank. As you can see, RNG is treating us very, very well in this battle. We are already sitting on 3000 damage and we are only 2.5 minutes into the battle. So once again, when those games are happening, when enemies are going in front of your gun, fellas, any tank can work. It doesn't matter, are you playing with a cow, a MX tier 7 or tier 8, or are you playing with something else? By the way, this is high explosive ammunition and we are smacking him for 460 in the face with the high explosives. This is unseen and this is kind of unreal how lucky that roll of the damage was, don't you think so? Obviously, one more thing which I have to ask, fellas, if you have ever played with a tier 8 Chinese tank destroyer, please let me know in the comment section down below. And what do you think? Maybe you disagree with me and maybe you think this tank is actually very good and what I am saying, it doesn't make absolutely any sense, and I should learn how to play and I should learn how to make a content. Maybe feel free to do so. I can't wait to hear your opinion. And now one more thing which I definitely want to highlight about this tank overall. If you want to play with a tank destroyer which have a humongous alpha damage, I would say ISU is so much better than this. Armor wise, obviously this tank destroyer is not working, neither ISU does, although ISU is getting more random bounces from time to time, and this is definitely worth thing to highlight. I noticed that our team is winning the game. It's 9-2 situation, current world of tanks, so we are just going in front, we are snapping the T and Hash in the face, and that worked just great. Meanwhile, enemy CS 53 is saying hell no, I'm out, and I am saying not so fast. Take this one in the butt and then you can go. Once again, ideal score, ideal situation. Well, speaking about the score, I mean 15 to 3 is never ideal, but this is but speaking about this battle, it is pretty damn impressive the score which we have with this vehicle when situation is looking like this, don't you think so? ELC even was trying to run for his life, not so fast, buddy. Meanwhile, Ergashem is getting spotted in the middle. What that means? That means we are going to take our time to hit him 500 in the face, and this is the score which we have. PP raised, and I know at this point I am yelling in the stream, I am saying, and fellas, do you think we are going to suffer with this vehicle? No. And you know what, funny thing, I was absolutely correct about this. We dealt with it very quickly and we did very good job. I am truly proud of myself, and believe me, it is not happening that often when I can say so. Anyways, let's teleport into the scoreboard and let's see what do we have. Let's go. And we are back. So those are the two games which I shared with you. First is in the Seren Coast and another is in Siegfried Line. It happened to be both of those games was played in the same day when we had this legendary session. I am lucky bastard. So let's see. The first battle we got 1.6 base experience, 5,800 damage, 800 assisting damage, and we made 44,000 profits, which is very nice. In the second game, we had 5,500 damage, a quick 5 minutes game, that was definitely quick, and we got 1.3 base experience a game. I had a better game damage wise, but only by 70 damage than the one which I shared with you, and it was camping Fiesta. I was sitting next to the red line, so I honestly thought it is not even worth to show this score, honestly. And overall, we had quite a bit of the 4,000 plus games, but one more thing which I want to say, fellas, don't think this tank is amazing and this tank is good. I had plenty of battles where I did one shot of damage. It has 560 alpha damage. I had plenty of those games, fellas, and as you can see, one shot, one shot, one shot, one shot, one shot, and look at that humongous amount of the games where I scored only couple of shots in the battle. So don't be tricked by this video and don't think this is the best tank in the world of tanks and there is no better tanks than this. Fellas, trust me on this one, that tank is not good, that tank is not really nice, and that tank is not really playable. I really want to put that out of the way, right? And just to not to give people false impressions. And once again, session which we had for a last time to flex with it, and it was absolutely amazing, fellas. I am feeling very, very proud of this score. So, thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill. I hope you had a great time, and I hope you enjoyed yourself. And obviously, thank you very much for watching, and see you very, very soon. Skill is out for today. Peace.